गुड मॉर्निंग, मैं ऑडिबल?
यस मैम,
यस,
ऑडिबल?
माय स्क्रीन इज विजिबल?
नो मैम.
यस, एम आई ऑडिबल?
यस मैम.
Okay, good afternoon all of you. Am I audible?
Yes ma'am.
Okay, please wait, I will share screen. Okay, screen is visible?
Yes ma'am.
Okay, general guidelines on construction of SFD and BMD. This slide is visible, na?
Yes ma'am.
Okay, so in last lecture we have discussed general guidelines on construction of SFD and BMD. So today we will discuss interpretations, that means at the time of drawing shear force and bending moment diagram for simply supported beam with point load, uniformly varying load and uniformly distributed load, which points we have to remember. So next point is interpretations. Now this slide is visible?
No ma'am.
No ma'am.
Wait, I will share once again. Okay, now?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, so today we will discuss these interpretations. That means whenever we will draw shear force and bending moment diagram, at that time, which points we have to remember. Okay, so please see carefully this table. Carefully this table. In that, first is types of loading point. Okay, first is types of loading. After that, shape of shear force diagram. Okay, and last one is shape of bending moment diagram. So this table is totally related to simply supported beam only. Okay. So already we have solved four numericals on this simply supported beam. Simply supported beam with point load, this is first. Second is simply supported beam with uniformly distributed load. Third one is simply supported beam with uniformly varying load. And last one is simply supported beam with moment couple. Okay, now we will see if simply supported beam is there. Okay, if simply supported beam and one point load is applied. Simply supported beam and one point load is applied at that time. The shape of shear force diagram and shape of bending moment diagram. Okay. Okay, so please see here, whenever we will draw shear force diagram and bending moment diagram for this point load, okay, this point load at that time, sudden jump at load and constant at other locations. So suppose this is simply supported beam and shear force diagram is likewise. Shear force diagram is likewise. So sudden jump at load and constant at other location. म्हणजे बघा point A, suppose this is A point, this is B point and C point. So in between A to C, म्हणजे A to C मध्ये कुठलाही force नाहीये, तर diagram काय असणार आहे आपली constant असणार आहे. पण जर एखादा load act होत असेल तर त्यावेळी मात्र काय होते sudden drop down. हा काय असेल तुमची shear force diagram चा shape असेल. लक्षात ठेवा तर shear force diagram मध्ये काय होतं कि ज्या ठिकाणी लोड ऍक्ट केला जातो त्या ठिकाणी शियर फोर्स डायग्राम सडन ड्रॉप डाऊन होते म्हणजे त्याच्यात काय होतात चेंजेस होतात आणि अदर ठिकाणी काय राहते कॉन्स्टंट राहते. देन नेक्स्ट वी विल सी शेप ऑफ बेंडिंग मूवमेंट डायग्राम. शेप ऑफ बेंडिंग मूवमेंट डायग्राम. सो शेप ऑफ बेंडिंग मूवमेंट डायग्राम फॉर दिस लाईकवाईज ना. And the value of bending moment is WL by 4. And here x raised to power is 1. That's why the shape of bending moment diagram is linearly varying graph or linearly inclined straight line. Okay, got it? So related to point load, you have to remember sudden jump. सडन जंप म्हणजे काय होतं इथं की सडन चेंजेस होतात. कधी होतात? ज्यावेळी लोड ऍक्ट केला जातो त्यावेळी सडन चेंजेस होतात. आणि ज्या ठिकाणी लोड नाहीये त्या ठिकाणी ती काय राहते डायग्राम कॉन्स्टंट राहते. तर बेंडिंग मुवमेंट मध्ये काय होतं लिनियरली व्हॅरिंग ग्राफ आहे इन्क्लाइंड स्ट्रेट लाईन आहे. बिकॉज ऑफ हियर एक्स रेस टू पॉवर इज 1 दॅट्स वाय द शेप ऑफ बेंडिंग मुवमेंट डायग्राम इज लिनियरली व्हॅरिंग ऑर इन्क्लाइंड स्ट्रेट लाईन. ओके, सो दिस पॉइंट इज रिलेटेड टू पॉइंट कट. नाव वी विल डिस्कस फॉर दिस युनिफॉर्मली डिस्ट्रीब्युटेड लोड. For this uniformly distributed load. So for this beam is likewise. Suppose this is simply supported beam AB. Okay. And on that beam uniformly distributed load is applied. Okay. So now you tell me for this figure the shape of shear force diagram is which type of shape we have drawn? Yes, anyone? Yes, please. You see previous pages and accordingly you tell me. Yes.
A rectangular
or which shape is there? Okay, you have to freedom. You draw here shear force diagram. You draw. Let me, I will check. Yes, you are able to draw shear force diagram. So you draw here shear force diagram. Yes, which type of shape is there? No, you are drawing load. I am asking shear force diagram. Yes, draw. You have to freedom. So please draw. Try to draw at least. Already we have solved. That's why I am asking.
Okay, ma'am.
Okay. Okay, also those students are present in classroom. You tell me, what is the shape of shear force diagram? Yes, anyone at least try to draw, because of I have opened this annotation. You try to draw. Yes, please, anyone.
Inclined straight line.
Inclined straight line. So you draw here. I have drawn here baseline. You try from your mobile. Okay, I will draw here. Likewise, na? This shape is, na?
No, ma'am.
Okay. Then?
Middle madun straight line. Eka side varun varti geche. Eka side khali ani. Straight line.
Likewise?
Ha.
Okay, so this is the shear force diagram. Snehal, now you draw bending moment diagram. Okay, so this is the shear force diagram. Here the value of shear force is W by yes, value of shear force for uniformly distributed load.
WL by 2.
Okay, and here also WL by 2. But above baseline diagram is positive and below baseline diagram is negative. So this is the shear force diagram. Okay. So you observe here, again, X raised to power is 1. X raised to power is 1. That's why the shape of the shear force diagram is linearly varying graph. That means inclined straight line is there. Okay. So you have to remember, whenever uniformly distributed load is applied, at that time shape of this shear force diagram is inclined straight line or linearly varying graph. Okay. Now we will discuss related to this bending moment diagram. Okay. So now Snehal, you draw your bending moment diagram, or anyone. Which shape is there? Yes. For simply supported beam, uniformly distributed load is applied. At that time, the shape of bending moment diagram is parabolic. Okay, is parabolic. And this parabolic shape is due to, now you tell me, the value of bending moment is WL square by 8. Okay, now you observe here L square. That means X raised to power is 2. If the highest power of X is 2, at that time shape of this bending moment diagram is parabolic. Shape of bending moment diagram is parabolic. That's why we have drawn here parabolic shape. So you remember here, for uniformly distributed load, shear force diagram is inclined straight line or linearly varying graph. And for bending moment diagram, graph is parabolic. Why this parabolic? Because of X raised to power is 2. That's why shape is parabolic. Okay. Now we will move towards next point. That is uniformly varying load. Uniformly varying load. So this is our simply supported beam. On that beam, suppose uniformly varying load is applied likewise. Okay. So for this, shape of SF diagram is parabolic and shape of bending moment diagram is cubic polynomial, because of in the calculation of shear force, X raised to power is 2. So the shear force diagram is parabolic graph, and in bending moment diagram, X raised to power is 3. That's why the shape of this figure is cubical varying or cubic polynomial. Cubic polynomial, that means inverted parabolic. Okay. And last, that is moment couple. Okay. Last one is moment couple. For this moment couple, shear force, no effect, because of, suppose this is our simply supported beam and we have applied moment couple is here. So shear force at A, which is equal to 0, shear force at B, which is equal to 0. So in shear force diagram, there is no effect, but in bending moment diagram, sudden jump at moment and constant at other locations. That means At that point, okay, here we are applying movement. So at that point, sudden jump is there. And in remaining portion, diagram is constant. Okay, diagram is constant. Okay, for this, I will draw here. This is SFD, shear force diagram. Okay, hole is in negative and bending moment diagram is likewise we have drawn. Okay, here parabolic nature is there. Okay, so you observe here at point where movement is applied, at that time sudden jump is there. Okay, it kay hote baka tumcha sign change hote. Tar hechi diagram kay asel? In shear force there is no effect, but in bending moment diagram where load is applied, at that point sudden jump is there. And wherever load is not applied or movement is not applied, at that point diagram is constant. So you have to remember this table. Okay, because of on this table, one or two MCQ will be asked. Suppose simply supported beam is given and on that point load is applied. So shape of shear force diagram is, and four options given. This is first, second, third and fourth. Out of that, you have to choose one. So please remember this. Okay, you have drawn, written this table or not?
No, ma'am.
Okay, please write down fast. Write fast. So we will take next example.
Ma'am, तो parabolic का काढ़ा है जगह triangular ना काढ़ लेते चालू ना.
कुठलं विचारताय? कशाचा shape विचारताय? कशाचा शेप म्हणताय? पॅराबोलिकच काढायचा का?
युनिफॉर्मली वेअरिंग लोड.
युनिफॉर्मली वेअरिंग लोडचा. आता युनिफॉर्मली वेअरिंग लोड साठी शिअर फोर्स काढताना एक्स ची पॉवर टू आहे बघा. त्यामुळे जर एक्स ची पॉवर टू असेल तर डायग्राम आपल्याला कंपल्सरी पॅराबोलिक काढायची. एक्स ची पॉवर जर टू असेल तर कंपल्सरी पॅराबोलिक काढायची, आणि एक्स ची पॉवर थ्री असेल तर कंपल्सरी डायग्राम ही क्युबिक पॉलिनॉमियल ड्रॉ करायची. क्यूबिक पॉलिनोमियल. आणि जर एक्स रेस टू पॉवर वन असेल तर इनक्लाइंड स्ट्रेट लाइन और स्ट्रेट लाइन. स्ट्रेट लाइन, लिनियर स्ट्रेट लाइन आपल्याला ड्रॉ करायची. तर एक्स ची पॉवर जर वन असेल तर, आणि एक्स रेस टू झिरो असेल तर त्यावेळी फक्त हॉरिझॉन्टल लाइन आपल्याला ड्रॉ करायची. हे ह्याचे काय आहेत नोटेशन. एक्स रेस टू पॉवर झिरो ऍट दॅट टाइम ओनली हॉरिझॉन्टल लाईन विल बी देअर. एक्स रेस टू वन लिनियर स्ट्रेट लाईन इज देअर. एक्स रेस टू टू ऍट दॅट टाइम पॅराबोलिक डायग्राम वी हॅव टू ड्रॉ. अँड इफ एक्स रेस टू पॉवर इज थ्री ऍट दॅट टाइम क्युबिक पॉलिनोमियल. ओके, सो इन युनिफॉर्मली व्हॅरिंग लोड व्हेन एव्हर वी ड्रॉ शिअर फोर्स डायग्राम ऍट दॅट टाइम एक्स रेस टू पॉवर इज टू. सो वी हॅव टू कंपल्सरी ड्रॉ हिअर पॅराबोलिक ग्राफ. ओके, गॉट इट नाउ?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes. Please write fast. So we will solve next example. Okay, up till now we have solved these four problems. Okay, I will mark here. Which four? Suppose this is simply supported beam and point load, but central point load we have applied. After that, uniformly distributed load, we have solved this numerical. After that, uniformly varying load, we have solved this numerical also. Okay, after that, one moment couple is applied, we have solved. But one example is remaining. Simply supported beam is there. And on that beam, point load is applied, but not at center. So it is from A distance and B distance is there. So we have to solve this example. Only this example is remaining related to simply supported beam. Okay, let me know after your writing is over. So we will solve this problem. Yeah, I request all of you, please write down fast. Over.
No, ma'am. Over. Oh, hermano.
Okay, so we will solve next example, simply supported beam with point load, but not at center. Okay, so please wait, I will share whiteboard, then we will solve. Okay, my screen is visible, whiteboard is visible to you?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, so now we will solve. Okay, so simply supported beam with point load but not at center. I will draw figure simultaneously, you can also draw, then we will solve. So this is simply supported beam AB. And on that beam, one point load is applied at some distance from A support. At some distance from A support. Okay. So, this is point load and intensity of point load is W. This is A point. This is B point. Okay. Suppose this distance is A and this distance is B. So total distance is L meter. Okay, L meter span. So due to this W, two reactions will be there, RA and RB. So first we have to calculate reactions. So whenever we will solve this problem at that time, first step is our reaction calculation. Reaction calculations. Reaction calculations. Okay, now you tell me which sign conventions we will use for these reaction calculations. At that time, suppose first step is summation of vertical forces, which is equal to zero. At that time, which sign conventions we will use here? Yes, unmute.
Upward, positive,
upward, positive, downward, negative.
Okay, if force is going upward, we will consider positive. Force is going downward, we will consider negative. So according to these sign conventions, now you tell me here. Equation, summation of Fv, which is equal to zero. How I will write here? Yes, fast.
Ra plus Rb minus W.
Ra plus Rb minus W, which is equal to zero because of here only three forces are there vertical. Out of that, Ra and Rb going upward direction, so plus, and W going downward direction, so minus. So from this, Ra plus Rb, which is equal to w. So this is equation one. Now you tell me second equation is, what is our second equation for reaction calculation? Summation movement at any point which is equal to zero. So we will take movement at a point. So summation movement at a which is equal to zero. Now you tell me which sign conventions are applicable for this equation. Yes, clockwise positive and anti-clockwise negative. Okay, now we will start movement from this B point towards A point. So this RB force creates clockwise or anti-clockwise movement towards this A point? Anti-clockwise. So minus RB into, movement means force into perpendicular distance. So RB is the force and perpendicular distance is? Yes. RB into L. Okay. After that, this W creates clockwise movement towards A point. So plus W into perpendicular distance is A. Okay. We will consider A, which is equal to zero. Now we will shift this RB into L to right side. So therefore WA, which is equal to RB into L. So therefore RB, which is equal to WA divided by L. So this is the value of RB. Once you got the value of RB, next target is you have to put this value in equation one and find out the value of RA. Okay. So put RB in equation one. So our equation one is RA plus RB, which is equal to W. So RA plus WA into L, which is equal to W. Now we will shift this to right side. So RA, which is equal to W minus WA divided by L. Okay, so here denominator is 1. From this we will take W as a common. So what is remaining? RA, which is equal to W in bracket. Okay, simultaneously we will multiply here and we will make same denominator. So here 1 is remaining after taking W common. So and after multiplying this L. Okay, minus A divided by A. L minus A divided by A. Okay. So RA which is equal to. Now we will take this minus as a common. So minus W. I think we have. Okay. So minus. Okay. L minus A. Not need to taking minus common. Now you tell me L minus A, which is equal to how much? L minus A, which is equal to B distance is there. Okay, see here. A. You observe here A plus B, which is equal to L. A plus B, which is equal to L. So L minus A, which is equal to B. So we will write here B. So RA, which is equal to WB divided by L. Anybody having doubt regarding this? RA, which is equal to WB divided by L. Or I will give here reference B, which is equal to L minus A from this span. Okay. So RA, which is equal to WB upon L. And RB, which is equal to WA upon L. So we will write here RA, which is equal to WB divided by L. And RB, which is equal to WA divided by L. So these are the reactions calculations. After that, second step. Now you tell me, second step is shear force calculation. Shear force calculations. So here we have to calculate shear force. Okay. So whenever we will calculate shear force, at that time you have to remember, if beam is rotated clockwise, we will consider positive, and if beam is rotated anti-clockwise, we will consider negative. So we will start calculation from this A point. Okay. So shear force at A, which is equal to, shear force at A, which is equal to shear force at A, which is equal to shear force at A. Only one force is there, and this force is RA. So shear force at A, which is equal to plus WB divided by L. The value of RA is WB upon L. Okay, after that, we will calculate shear force. Suppose we will mark this is C point. Okay, shear force at C, but before W. Okay, next we will calculate shear force at C. Shear force at C. Shear force at C, but before W. Before W. That means without considering this W. काय असणार आहे बघा, ए पासून सी पर्यंत कुठला लोड ऍक्ट झालेला आहे का नाही आहे, म्हणजे व्हॅल्यू काय असणार आहे तुमची, एज इट इज असेल, प्लस डब्ल्यू बी डिवायडेड बाय एल. ओके, आफ्टर दॅट वी विल कॅल्क्युलेट शिअर फोर्स ऍट सी आफ्टर डब्ल्यू. ओके, नेक्स्ट पॉइंट इज शिअर फोर्स ऍट सी आफ्टर डब्ल्यू. सो शिअर फोर्स ऍट सी आफ्टर डब्ल्यू. Shear force at C after W. Okay. Now, before W, shear force value is WB upon L. Okay. WB upon L. After that, this W. Okay. This W pushes beam to anti-clockwise. So, this W creates minus sign. So, minus W. Okay. That much shear force is there. Now we will take W as a common from this. Okay, I will write here once again. So what is our equation? Shear force at C. Shear force at C, but after W. After W, which is equal to W B divided by L minus W. Now we will take W as a common from this. Okay. So which is equal to W in bracket. Same here we will multiply and make denominator same. So after this here B is remaining. Okay. And here 1 is remaining. So minus L divided by L. Okay. Divided by L. Now we will take this minus common. Okay. So minus W in bracket. Okay. So if we will take this minus common, at that time this minus L will plus L, and this plus B will minus B divided by L. Now, okay, our span is, you see here, A plus B, which is equal to L. So L minus B, which is equal to A. Okay. So, yes, we will write here L minus B, which is equal to A from this span. So now our equation is minus WA divided by L. This is the shear force at C after W. Anybody having doubt regarding this?
No.
Okay. Now last point is remaining, that is shear force at B. Shear force at B. So we will calculate here shear force at B, which is equal to, okay, up to this B point, okay, before considering reaction, okay, from this C to B, there is no any load. So shear force value is same, that is minus WA divided by L. But at this B point, okay, shear force at B before, we will write here, before RB. Before RB value as it is, because of there is no any load between C to B. And last we will calculate shear force at B, shear force at B after RB. That means after considering the force of RB or reaction of RB. So before this B point, shear force is minus WA divided by L, and this RB, that means it creates clockwise rotation. So plus WA divided by L. So minus WA plus WA gets cancelled, and shear force at B after RB, which is equal to 0 kilonewton. 0 kilonewton. So these are the shear force calculations. Anybody having any doubt in any point?
No, ma'am.
Okay. Now we will move towards bending moment calculation. Waiter, I will take new whiteboard. Okay. So now we will do calculations for bending moment. So our step third step is bending moment calculations. Bending moment calculations. I will draw figure once again here. So this is our simply supported beam. Load is applied, one point load, but not at center. So this is our figure. A point, this is B point. Here W is applied, this distance is A, this distance is B. The value of RA, which is equal to how much? W B divided by L, and RB, which is equal to WA divided by L. Okay, so now we will calculate bending moment. So you have to remember sign convention for bending moment calculation. If sagging nature is there, positive, hogging nature is there, negative. Okay, so we will start bending moment from this B point. Bending moment from this B point. So now you tell me bending moment at B, which is equal to how much? Bending moment at B, which is equal to, yes, how much bending moment at B? Zero, because the force is there, but this force is acting at B point, so perpendicular distance is zero. So bending moment at B, which is equal to WA divided by L into zero, which is equal to zero kilonewton meter. After that, next we will calculate bending moment at C point. We will calculate bending moment at C point. Okay. So next is bending moment at C. Bending moment at C, which is equal to bending moment at C, which is equal to. For this, I will draw figure here. So this is WA divided by L. Okay. And suppose our C point is here. Okay. And from this B to C point, perpendicular distance is B. Okay, perpendicular distance is B. So bending moment, which is equal to this force, WA pushes upward. That means, okay, whenever this pushes upward, at that time, this type of nature is occur. Okay, that means sagging. So plus WA divided by L. This is force into perpendicular distance is B, so which is equal to plus WAB divided by L kilonewton meter. So this is the bending moment at C point. Okay. Now we will calculate bending moment at A. Bending moment at A. So anyone tell me bending moment at A, which is equal to how much?
Zero.
Zero. Because of we have to calculate movement at A. Okay, we have to calculate. I will write here. Wait. So next is bending moment at A, which is equal to. So here RA force is there, but perpendicular distance is zero. So bending moment at A, which is equal to WB divided by L into perpendicular distance is zero. So which is equal to zero kilonewton meter. Okay, we have calculated this moment from this left side. Suppose you have to calculate from this right side. बघा हे right side कडून जर काढायचे असेल तर काय होईल तुमचे? Or मी इथे तुम्हाला calculate करून दाखवते. ठीक आहे. हा WA into L plus आहे. Okay, WA into divided by A into perpendicular distance is how much? L is there. Okay. And this W pushes downward. Okay. डब्ल्यू पुशेस डाउनवर्ड. सो माइनस डब्ल्यू इंटू ए डिवाइडेड बाय माइनस डब्ल्यू इंटू ए डिवाइडेड बाय ओनली डब्ल्यू इंटू ए ओनली डब्ल्यू इंटू ए. After that, we have to make same denominator here. So plus WAL minus WAL divided by L. So plus and minus gets cancelled. So bending moment, which is equal to zero. Either you have calculated moment from left side or right side, it will get same answer. So from left side, it is easy because of at A point force is there, but perpendicular distance is zero. So we will calculate from this side. Okay. So bending moment at A, which is equal to zero. Now our bending moment and shear force calculations are over. We will draw shear force and bending moment diagram. Please wait. So step number four is SFD and BMD, shear force diagram and bending moment diagram. So for that, first we will draw our given beam and then shear force diagram and bending moment diagram. So this is our simply supported beam. One load is applied here. Okay, we have to extend these all lines. So we will draw proportionate shear force and bending moment diagram. So this is A point, this is B point. Here W is applied and this is C point. Okay. Now I will draw baseline for shear force diagram. Baseline for shear force diagram. So now you tell me shear force at A point, which is equal to how much? WB upon L. Okay. So we will draw here WB upon L. After that, there is no force in between A to C. That means shear force diagram is constant up to this C point. After that, shear force at C, which is equal to how much? Shear force at C, which is equal to? Yes, we have calculated. Okay, at C point, there is downward force. That means our shear force diagram sudden jumps. म्हणजे इथे काय होणार आहे तर डायग्राम पॉझिटिव्ह कडून निगेटिव्ह कडे येणार आहे आणि व्हॅल्यू किती असणार आहे मग तुमची इथं मायनस डब्ल्यू ए अपॉन एल. ओके, सो बिफोर बी शिअर फोर्स इज मायनस डब्ल्यू ए अपॉन एल अँड ऍट बी शिअर फोर्स हियर क्लोजेस झिरो. सो दिस इज अवर शिअर फोर्स डायग्राम. सो शिअर फोर्स ऍट ए पॉइंट इज डब्ल्यू बी अपॉन एल. Here also same WB upon L. Here shear force is zero and here minus WA upon L. Here again no need to write minus sign. So here WA upon L and here zero. So whole diagram is in negative. This is whole in positive and this is the shear force diagram. Now we will draw bending moment diagram. So first I will draw base for bending moment diagram, then we will draw figure. Okay, so now you tell me bending moment at A, which is equal to
zero.
Bending moment at B, which is equal to
zero.
And bending moment at C, something value is there, but this value is positive. That means we have to draw bending moment diagram above baseline. So we will assume here W A B divided by L. And here suppose we have taken X section. Okay, for and here X raised to power is 1 will be there. So connection between two points for this bending moment diagram is inclined straight line. And whole diagram is in positive nature. So this is the bending moment diagram. If anybody having doubt, ask me. Otherwise, please write down fast. So we will solve numericals on cantilever beam. Anybody having doubt?
No.
Okay, no doubt. Then please write down fast. And let me know after your writing is over. This slide is over. Shall I go to next slide?
No, ma'am. Wait.
Okay.
Over, ma'am.
Please write down first. So students are present in classroom. You are writing this over. Let me know. Okay, so in that way our simply supported beam is over. Now we will move towards next beam, that is cantilever beam. Okay, but please wait for 2 minutes because of some students wants time for writing. Over now. Okay. So now we will take next example. Please write down heading cantilever beam examples. Cantilever beam examples. Okay. Snell, please off your video. Also mute yourself.
भूख खाली होने प्यार हाँ ले दूँगा.
Okay. So in cantilever beam, first we will take first example, that is cantilever beam with point load at free end point load at free end. So cantilever beam means one end is fixed and other end is free. So accordingly, I will draw figure. You can also draw. Then we will solve problem. So this is our cantilever beam. One end is fixed and other end is free. So A end of this beam is fixed and B end of this beam is free, and at free end one point load is applied and intensity is W. Intensity is W and the span of this beam is L meter. Okay. Now this end is fixed. So one vertical reaction will be there. This is called as RA. And due to this fixed support, one moment will be there. One moment will be there. We will mark as a MA. We will mark as a MA. Okay. So this is the figure. So according to our steps, first step is reaction calculation. Okay. First step is reaction calculation. Reaction calculation. So in reaction calculation, then again summation FV, which is equal to zero. That means all vertical forces, we have to take addition of all vertical forces, which is equal to zero. Upward forces we will consider positive, downward forces we will consider negative. Here only one reaction is there, RA, and at free end there is no reaction. Okay, so RA going upward direction, so plus RA, and this W going downward direction, so minus W, which is equal to zero. Therefore, you will get the value of RA, which is equal to W. RA, which is equal to W. After that, second step, that is summation moment at any point, which is equal to zero. So summation moment at any point, which is equal to zero, we will take moment at A point. So summation moment at A, which is equal to zero. For this, clockwise movement we will consider positive and anti-clockwise we will consider negative. So this W creates clockwise movement towards this A point. Okay. So according to this, W into L, and this MA is anti-clockwise. So minus MA, which is equal to zero. So automatically you will get MA, which is equal to W into L. So this is the value of RA and MA into, sorry, value of MA. Then second step. In second step, we have to do calculations for shear force. Calculations for shear force. So second step is shear force calculations. Shear force calculations. So for this, beam rotate clockwise we will consider positive, beam rotate anti-clockwise we will consider negative. So according to, first we will calculate shear force at A. So now you tell me shear force at A, which is equal to, shear force at A, which is equal to, only one force is there, only one force, this RA. So RA, which is equal to plus W kilonewton. Okay. After that, we will calculate shear force at any point. Okay. Shear force at any point. So shear force at any point from A. Any point from A. So suppose we will take section at X distance. Okay. Suppose this is XX section. And here force is there. The value of RA, which is equal to W. So here W force is there. For this W, we have to apply opposite balancing force. Okay, opposite force. So here we have to apply this W. Okay, this W. So this is the shear force. Shear force. So shear force at any point from A, or shear force at any point X from A, which is equal to, काय असेल मग कुठली व्हॅल्यू येणार आहे, फक्त हा एकच W आहे आणि तो पण काय होतोय तुमचा क्लॉकवाइज जातोय, सो विच इज इक्वल टू W kilonewton. ओके, W kilonewton. बट वी हॅव टेकन दिस डिस्टन्स इज X, वी हॅव कन्सिडर्ड दिस डिस्टन्स इज X, शिअर फोर्स इज ओनली W. हिअर मल्टीप्लाइंग डिस्टेंस इज रिक्वायर्ड और नॉट नॉट रिक्वायर्ड बिकॉज ऑफ इन शियर फोर्स ओनली वी विल कंसिडर फोर्स सो हियर एक्स रेस टू पावर इज विच एक्स रेस टू पावर इज का पावर जीरो असणार आहे का कारण इथे मल्टीप्लाइंग डिस्टन्स घेतो का आपण घेणार नाहीये शिअर फोर्स म्हणजे काय असतं फक्त वर्टिकल फोर्सेस म्हणून इथं एक्स ची पॉवर काय असणार आहे झिरो आणि ज्या ठिकाणी एक्स रेस टू झिरो देन शिअर फोर्स डायग्राम कनेक्शन एस एफ डायग्राम कनेक्शन इज हॉरिझॉन्टल लाईन कनेक्शन इज हॉरिझॉन्टल लाईन प्लीज रिमेंबर दिस हॉरिझॉन्टल लाईन horizontal line so shear force at x distance which is equal to only w this x is not will consider because of in shear force we will not consider perpendicular distance after that we will calculate shear force at b but before w kay asel before w value shear force ji which is equal to before w जी व्हॅल्यू ए पॉइंटला आहे तीच व्हॅल्यू तुमची बिफोर डब्ल्यू असणार आहे ए टू बी मध्ये कुठलाही लोड आहे का नाहीये सो शिअर फोर्स ऍट बी बिफोर डब्ल्यू विच इज इक्वल टू प्लस डब्ल्यू किलो न्यूटन प्लस डब्ल्यू किलो न्यूटन अँड नाऊ लास्ट वी विल कॅल्क्युलेट शिअर फोर्स at b but after w now you tell me shear force at b after w so before w value is plus w and this w rotate beams anti clockwise okay so here anti clockwise so minus w which is equal to 0 so shear force at b which is equal to 0 kilonewton so these are the shear force calculations now we will move towards bending moment calculations okay we will move towards bending moment calculations so next step number 3 bending moment calculations so We will start from this B point. Now you tell me bending moment at B, which is equal to how much? Zero kilonewton meter. After that, we will calculate bending moment at X distance from this B point. Okay, from this B point. You observe here W is there but perpendicular distance is not. So I will expand here. Bending moment is 0 kilonewton. Before that I will write here W into 0 but this W pushes downward. Okay. So minus W into 0 which is equal to 0 kilonewton meter. After that, we will find bending moment at X distance. Bending moment at X from B point. Okay. So for this figure is likewise. Here W is applied and here XX section is taken. Perpendicular distance is suppose we have considered X distance. Okay. So now you tell me bending moment which is equal to how much? This W pushes downward. So minus W into X is there. And here X raised to power is 1. So bending moment diagram is linear inclined line. Okay, linear inclined line. And now we will calculate bending moment at A. Bending moment at A. So for finding out bending moment at A, value of x which is equal to how much we have to put bending moment at A. At that time, put x which is equal to how much? जर आपल्याला A point ला bending moment काढायचे असेल तर x चे distance किती put करावं लागेल इथं? L value put kar, yes, L bend at x which is equal to L. So bending moment at A which is equal to this minus W. Okay, this W going downward, so minus W into perpendicular distance is L kilonewton meter. Kilonewton meter. So these are the calculations for bending moment. Okay. Now we will draw shear force and bending moment diagram. Okay. Last step, step number 4 is shear force diagram and bending moment diagram. First, I will draw figure, then we will draw. So this is our beam, one end is fixed and at free end one point load is applied. We will extend all lines. So A end is fixed. This is A, this is B end, and here W is applied and the span of this beam is L. So shear force diagram, shear force at A point is W, okay, plus W. So diagram is above baseline. After that, there is no load in between A to B, okay, before B, okay. So W is constant. W is constant up to this W, and after that this W comes, so force will be sudden drop down, so here G. So this is our shear force diagram and whole diagram is in positive, so here value is W, here also W. So this is shear force diagram, this is A point and this is B point. Now we will draw bending moment diagram. So bending moment diagram, the values of bending moment diagram are in negative, so we will draw bending moment diagram below baseline. So bending moment at B point, which is equal to zero, and bending moment at A point is minus W into L. So here W into L, and this is A point and this is B point. Okay, so the x raised to power is 1, that's why the connection of this bending moment diagram is linear inclined straight line. Linear inclined straight line. This diagram is a below baseline because of all values in negative, so minus, and this is bending moment diagram. I request all of you, please write down fast. So we will solve next example.
Recording in progress.
प्रेस केलं का ते जोरात नाही ते दिसत तुम्ही प्रेस करा आता एकच नाही आता करा बरं चालू थांबा 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 चालू होते स्क्रीन इज विजिबल टू यू
यस मैम
ओके प्लीज राइट डाउन फास्ट मोबाईल काढलाय का ठेव बँक मध्ये Okay, you are this slide is over. Shall I show next slide? Yes. Yes, ma'am. Okay. ओके वन स्टूडेंट हैव आस्क्ड शियर फोर्स एंड बेंडिंग मोमेंट कैलकुलेशन रिपीट वंस अगेन सो आई विल रिपीट वंस अगेन यू ऑब्जर्व हियर एट ए पॉइंट ओनली वन रिएक्शन इज देयर सो शियर फोर्स एट ए व्हिच इज इक्वल टू डब्ल्यू किलोन्यूटन After that, we have to calculate shear force at x distance from this A point. So figure is here W is applied. For this opposite force is required. So this W, okay. And it rotates beam clockwise. So plus W is there. But here perpendicular distance is not required. So x raised to power is zero. That means connection between shear force diagram is horizontal line. After that, we have to find out shear force at B. बट बिफोर डब्ल्यू म्हणजे हा डब्ल्यू कन्सिडर करण्यापूर्वी काय असणार आहे तुमचा ए पॉइंटला जेवढा शेअर फोर्स आहे तेवढाच कुठे असेल तुमचा बी पॉइंटला पण असेल म्हणून व्हॅल्यू काय आली तुमची प्लस डब्ल्यू ऍज इट इज आफ्टर दॅट शिअर फोर्स ऍट बी ओके शिअर फोर्स ऍट बी आणि आपण सेक्शन काय घेतोय बीच्या पुढे घेतोय तर ह्या बी मुळे बीम हा अँटी क्लॉकवाईज रोटेट होतो म्हणून इथे काय आलो मायनस सो प्लस डब्ल्यू मायनस डब्ल्यू विच इज इक्वल टू झिरो सो दिस इज शिअर फोर्स कॅल्क्युलेशन And bending moment. So bending moment at B. Force is there, but perpendicular distance is zero. So W into zero, which is equal to zero kilonewton. And this W pushes beam to downward. That means hogging nature is there. So minus W. After that, we have to find out bending moment at X distance from B point. So figure is W load is applied here and distance is X. So this W pushes downward. That means bending moment nature is hogging nature that is this type of and this is minus so minus w into perpendicular distance is x and here x raised to power is 1 that's why the connection between two points for bmd is linear inclined line after that we have to find out bending moment at a point so when we get bending moment at a after putting x which is equal to l so W pushes downward, so minus W into perpendicular distance from this B to A, perpendicular distance is L, so minus W into L kilonewton meter. So these are the bending moment calculations. Okay, please draw this shear force and bending moment diagram fast. Then we will take next example. Draw fast. Let me know after your drawing is over. Over.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So please write down next example. Cantilever beam with uniformly distributed load throughout span. Cantilever beam with UDL throughout span. So this is cantilever beam AB. A end is fixed, B end is free, and here uniformly distributed load is applied throughout the span. Intensity is W kilonewton per meter. Okay, so and the span for this beam is L meter. Okay, due to this uniformly distributed load, one reaction will be there. This is RA, and due to this fixed support, one movement is there, and movement is MA. Okay, so first step, reaction calculation. So in reaction calculation, first point is summation FV, which is equal to zero. Upward forces positive, downward forces negative. So only two forces are there. So RA going upward, RA, then this W going downward. So minus W into this uniformly distributed load. So we have to multiply here L, which is equal to zero. So RA, which is equal to WL. RA, which is equal to WL. You will get direct value of RA. After that, second equation you have to apply, that is summation movement at A, which is equal to zero. We will apply here summation movement at A, which is equal to zero. So this MA is anti-clockwise, so minus MA. So here sign conventions, positive clockwise and negative anti-clockwise. So MA is anti-clockwise, and this W creates clockwise movement. Okay, so plus W into L, that is UDL to point load, and it will act at L by 2 distance, which is equal to 0. Now we will shift this MA to right side. So therefore, MA which is equal to W L square divided by 2. W L square divided by 2. Now reaction calculation part is over. We will move towards shear force calculation point. So second step is shear force calculation. So the value of RA, which is equal to how much? W into L. Okay, value of RA is W into L. So first we will calculate shear force at A. So shear force at A, which is equal to, only one force is there, RA. So which is equal to plus WL. Okay. After that, we will calculate shear force at X distance. Okay. So I will draw figure here. Next point is shear force at X distance. So figure is likewise. Suppose here W into L is there. This is XX section and this distance is X meter. Okay. And here uniformly distributed load is applied, W kilonewton per meter. Okay. So shear force at X, which is equal to, so this plus WL as it is, W into L. Now this W creates anti-clockwise rotation. So minus W into X. Why I have multiplied by X here? Anyone please? We have X ni ka multiply kele ho ito?
Uniformly
distributed load ahe. Tala point load madhe convert karnyasathi apan X ni multiply kele. Perpendicular distance ghyachi garaj nahi hai. Shear force calculation karto hai apan. Tar uniformly distributed load आहे त्याला पॉइंट लोड मध्ये कन्वर्ट करण्यासाठी आपण इथं x ने मल्टीप्लाई केले. नाउ यू ऑब्जर्व हियर x रेस टू पावर इज 1. सो आवर शियर फोर्स डायग्राम इज लीनियर. Now we will calculate shear force at B point. Shear force at B, which is equal to shear force at B. So for calculating shear force at B, we have to put x which is equal to L distance. X which is equal to L. So shear force at B, which is equal to, okay, plus WL and this minus W into x. Instead of this x, we will put this L distance. So plus W minus W, which is equal to 0 kilonewton. So shear force at B, which is equal to 0. Now step number 3, that is bending moment calculations. Bending moment calculations. We will start from B point. Now you tell me bending moment at B, which is equal to how much? Yes, bending moment at B, which is equal to? Bending moment at B, automatically it will comes 0 because of there is here at B point perpendicular distance is 0. So bending moment at B is 0 kilonewton meter. After that, we will calculate bending moment at x distance from B. Bending moment at x from B. From B point. That means we will take distance from B point. Okay. So this is B. This is XX section. Here B point is there. Here W is applied and perpendicular distance is X. So now you tell me bending moment at X, which is equal to how much? This W force pushes downward. That means minus W into X because of uniformly distributed load to point load into it will act its CG. So into X by 2 into X divided by 2. So which is equal to moment, which is equal to minus W X square divided by 2. And here X raised to power is 2. So bending moment diagram is parabolic. Bending moment diagram is parabolic. Okay. So this is value of bending moment at x distance. But we have to calculate bending moment at A. So anyone please tell me how to calculate bending moment at A? By putting which value? X which is equal to how much? L. So bending moment at A, which is equal to, that is X, which is equal to L. X, which is equal to L. So bending moment, which is equal to minus W into L square divided by 2. Tar te kasa ala baga? L square divided by 2. Baga, ithe kaya hai tumcha W force hai. Suppose this is our figure. Okay, this is W. This is B point. This is A point. Okay, and distance. A to B distance is L meter. So this W pushes downward. So minus W into L because of UDL to point load. And it will act at L by 2.
L by 2.
So minus W L square by 2 kilonewton meter. So bending moment at A, which is equal to minus W L square by 2 kilonewton meter. So this is our bending moment calculations are over. After that, we will draw shear force and bending moment diagram here. So last step, that is shear force and bending moment diagram. Step number 4, SFD, SFD and BMD, SFD and BMD. First, I will draw given figure. So given beam is likewise. One end is fixed, other end is free. So out of that, A end is fixed. I will extend all lines. So we will draw proportionate diagram. this is A point, this is B point, and here throughout uniformly distributed load is applied W kilonewtons per meter and span is L. So shear force at A point, which is equal to how much? You read calculations and tell me shear force at A. You observe here, shear force at A is plus WL. So above baseline, plus WL. And after that, you tell me shear force at B, which is equal to?
Zero.
So here, zero. And here, x raised to power is 1. So shear force diagram is inclined straight line. Okay. Shear force diagram is inclined straight line. Whole diagram is in positive. So this is shear force diagram. The value of shear force at A is WL and at B is 0. So this is A point, this is B point. Now we will draw bending moment diagram. First, I will draw here baseline. So you observe here, the values of bending moments are negative. So bending moment diagram is below baseline. Okay, so bending moment at A, which is equal to minus WL square by 2. That means below baseline, it will come. And bending moment at B, which is equal to 0. Bending moment at B, which is equal to 0. But you observe here, x raised to power is how much? In bending moment calculation, x raised to power is here 2. X raised to power is 2. So bending moment diagram is in parabolic nature. So you have to draw like parabola. And whole diagram is in negative. So please remember, this is parabolic nature. And this diagram is bending moment diagram. Okay. And this is inclined straight line. The value of bending moment at A is WL square divided by 2. Okay. Please write down fast and let me know after your writing is over. completed your writing or you want time?
One minute.
Okay, your writing is over.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, so we will take next example, that is movement couple is applied. Okay, so next type is cantilever beam with movement couple. Next type is Or next example is cantilever beam with movement couple at free end. So I will draw figure. You can also draw. Okay, so this is AB beam and one moment couple is applied at B point. Span for this AB beam is L meter, and due to this one reaction will be there, and this is RA and fixed support is there, so one moment will be there. The moment is MA. So accordingly our first step is reaction calculation. Reaction calculation. So upward force we will consider positive and downward force we will consider negative. So first equation we will apply summation FV, which is equal to zero. Now you tell me here which force is applied here, only RA, which is equal to zero because of there is no any force. This M is there, but this is movement. So RA, which is equal to zero. After that, we will apply second equation, summation movement at A, which is equal to zero. Summation movement at A, which is equal to zero. This M creates clockwise movement. So, plus M. And this MA creates anti-clockwise movement. So, minus MA, which is equal to zero. Therefore, MA, which is equal to M. MA, which is equal to M. So these are the reactions calculations. After that, step number second is shear force calculations. So now you tell me shear force at A, which is equal to how much? Yes, shear force at A, which is equal to RA force is there, but the value of Ra is
zero.
So shear force at A, which is equal to 0 kilonewton. After that, we will calculate shear force at B. So shear force at B, which is equal to, now you observe here there is no any force. So shear force at B, which is equal to again 0 kilonewton, 0 kilonewton. And shear force in between A to B, A to B मध्ये कुठला फोर्स आहे का? नाहीये. म्हणजे शिअर फोर्स बिटवीन बिटवीन ए अँड बी विच इज इक्वल टू अगेन 0 kilonewton. सो हियर द व्हॅल्यू ऑफ शिअर फोर्सेस आर 0 फॉर ए बी अँड इन बिटवीन ए टू बी. नाऊ स्टेप नंबर 3. स्टेप नंबर 3 इज रिलेटेड टू बेंडिंग मोमेंट कॅल्क्युलेशन्स. सो वी विल calculate here bending moment calculations. Bending moment calculations. Okay, we will start from B point. So bending moment at B, which is equal to how much? Anyone? According to this figure, bending moment at B, which is equal to? बघा, B point ला इथे M act होतोय, म्हणजे मोमेंट काय असणार आहे इथे? M असणार आहे. ओके, सो बेंडिंग मुवमेंट ऍट बी विच इज इक्वल टू प्लस एम किलो न्यूटन मीटर. आफ्टर दॅट वी विल कॅल्क्युलेट बेंडिंग मुवमेंट. ओके, बट यू ऑब्झर्व हियर दिस एम पुशेस अपवर्ड ऑर डाउनवर्ड टू बीम? डाउनवर्ड. सो साइन विल बी प्लस ऑर मायनस? इफ beam pushes downward, then minus. That means hogging nature will be there. So minus m kilonewton meter. After that, we will find out bending moment at x from B. Bending moment at x. Bending moment at x distance. So beam is likewise, here moment is applied m, and here section is xx, perpendicular distance is x. Okay, so bending moment at x, which is equal to how much? This m pushes downward, so minus m. The x distance kya hola gaya kao perpendicular distance? Consider karai cha kai the ka nahi? Yes, anyone? Nahi karai cha. Ka karai cha nahi? Tar ite already moment dileli hai. Jar ha force asta tar apan consider kela asta. Here, already moment is given, so we will not consider this x. Okay, we will not consider this x. That means x raised to power is 0. So bending moment diagram is, bending moment diagram is horizontal line. Horizontal. Bending moment diagram is horizontal. Now we will calculate bending moment at A. Bending moment at A. So now you tell me bending moment at A, which is equal to bending moment at A. So whenever we have to find out bending moment at A, we will put x, which is equal to L. That is x, which is equal to L. So bending moment, which is equal to minus m into L. But we will calculate moment from this MA point, this A. But you observe here, moment is given. Yes, moment is given. So how you multiply by this perpendicular distance? Karav lagel ka m ni? Nahi karav lagel. Manje moment ka asnare tumchi fakt m asel. Hi right side kadun mila. Tej jar mi left side kadun kadaychi mhutla tar or from A side. From A side. So bending moment at A, which is equal to. So this pushes again beam to downward. That means hogging nature will be there. So the value of MA, value of MA is minus M. So bending moment at A point, which is equal to minus MA, which is equal to minus M, minus M kilonewton meter, minus M kilonewton meter. Now bending moment and shear force calculations are over. So we will draw figure. Okay, we will draw figure. Step number 4, SFD and BMD. So shear force at A, B and in between A to B, which is equal to 0. So shear force diagram is only horizontal line will be there because of 0 value is there. Huh? So this is shear force diagram. This is A point and this is B point. After that, we will draw bending moment diagram. Okay. So bending moment values are minus. So you observe bending moment at B minus M, bending moment at A minus M. So bending moment diagram is below or above baseline? Below baseline. So bending moment at A is minus M and bending moment at B is also minus M. So we will close the value. Horizontal line will be there. So this is negative and this is bending moment diagram. Here minus M value will be there. Please write down fast. So we will solve examples on simply supported beam.
Ma'am.
Yes.
Summation of vertical forces मध्ये minus m कशावर ठरवलं तुम्ही?
कुठलं म्हणताय?
हे पहिले equation.
हा summation fp which is equal to 0. हे ma which is equal to हे जे काही व्हॅल्यू आलेली आहे ही आपण एम ए विच इज इक्वल टू एम कॅल्क्युलेट केली इथं पण इथं ज्यावेळी आपण बेंडिंग मुवमेंट
ए प्लस एम ए मायनस प्लस एम मायनस एम इज इक्वल टू झिरो तर मायनस एम ए कशावरून ठरवलं
ते कशावरून ठरवलं आता इथं बघा हा एम जो आहे हा एम कुठल्या साईडनी मुवमेंट करतोय क्लॉकवाईज मुवमेंट आहे का अँटी क्लॉकवाईज मुवमेंट आहे ए पॉइंट कडे
क्लॉकवाईज
क्लॉकवाईज आहे म्हणून आपण इथे काय घेतलं प्लस घेतलं आणि हा जो काही एम ए आहे हा एम ए ए भोवती क्लॉकवाईज मुवमेंट करतोय का अँटी क्लॉकवाईज करतोय
अँटी क्लॉकवाईज
म्हणून मायनस घेतलं
ते प्रॉब्लेम मध्ये देताना तसं एरो देतात का आपण कन्सिडर करावं लागतं
आपण कन्सिडर करायचं की इथे जर समजा आता इथे बघा ही रिएक्शन होती अपवर्ड साईडला म्हणजे त्याला बॅलन्स करण्यासाठी डाऊनवर्ड फोर्सची गरज आहे ना आपल्याला लक्षात येते का तुमच्या हा फोर्स काय होतोय तुमचा आर ए अपवर्ड साईडला जातोय मग ह्याला बॅलन्स करण्यासाठी कुठला फोर्स साईड आहे तुम्हाला डाऊनवर्ड म्हणून आपण अज्युम करायचं की एम ए हा डाऊनवर्ड डिरेक्शन आहे जर तीच फिगर अशी असेल ऐका हे फिक्स्ड एंड आहे ओके आणि इथं मुवमेंट अप्लाय केली तर आता इथं सांगा बरं कसं घेणार तुम्ही असं कन्सिडर करणार का म्हणजे हा अपवर्ड चाललाय ह्याला डाऊनवर्ड जे आपल्याला काय करायचंय की अपवर्ड फोर्स आहे त्याला बॅलन्स करण्यासाठी मुवमेंट द्यायची आहे म्हणून आपण ती डाऊनवर्ड ओके प्लीज राइट डाऊन फास्ट let me know after your writing is over. So we will solve one example with values. Okay, till now we have solved example with respect to W and L, but now we will solve examples. The magnitude of W is given and span is given. Okay, your writing is over. Okay, write down fast. Over. Okay, please write down next heading. Numericals on simply supported beam. Write down next heading. Numericals on simply supported beam. So we have to draw shear force and bending moment diagram. So please write down draw SFD and BMD for given beam below. I will draw figure simultaneously. You can also draw. Okay, simply supported beam AE is given. On that beam, 3 point loads are applied. First is 20 kilonewton. Second one is 30 kilonewton. And third one is 10 kilonewton. Perpendicular distances or span for this is 3 meter, this is 2 meter, span between C to D is 3 meter and span between D to E is 2 meter. Okay, so we have to draw shear force and bending moment diagram for this beam. So here RA will be there and here RE will be there. We have to solve problem. Now you tell me, first step is which step? Reaction calculation. But in reaction calculation, first is summation FV, which is equal to zero. And for this, upward force we will consider positive, downward force we will consider negative. So this RA and RE going upward. So RA plus RE. Now this 20, 30 and 10 kilonewton force going downward direction. So minus 20, minus 30, minus 10, which is equal to 0. So RA plus RE, which is equal to RA plus RE, which is equal to, we will shift this minus 20, minus 30 and minus 10 to right side. So plus 20, plus 30, plus 10. Now you tell me RA plus RE, which is equal to how much? 20 plus 30 is 50 and 50 plus 10, that is 60 kilonewton. This is our equation first. After that, we will apply second equation, summation moment at A, which is equal to zero. So this RE creates anticlockwise moment. So minus RB into perpendicular distance is 2 plus 3 plus 2 plus 3, which is equal to how much? 3 plus 2, 5. 5 plus 3, 8. 8 plus 2 is 10. Okay. After that, this 10 kilonewton creates clockwise movements. So plus 10 into perpendicular distance is 3 plus 2 plus 3, 8 meter. Okay. After that, this 30 creates clockwise movement. So plus 30 into perpendicular distance is 5 meter. Okay. And this 20 kilonewton clockwise. So plus 20 into 2, which is equal to 0. We will shift this minus RB into 10 to right side. So 10 into 8 is 80 plus 30 into 5.
Into 3.
Yes.
20 into 3 meter.
20 into 3. Okay. 20 into 3. So 10 into 8 is 80 plus 30 into 5 is 150.
150.
Plus 20 into 3 is 60, which is equal to 10 RB. Okay. So now you take addition. 150 plus 60 plus 80, which is equal to how much?
290.
2?
90.
90 divided by 10, which is equal to RB. So RB, which is equal to?
29.
Therefore, RB, which is equal to 29 kilonewton. We will put this RB value in equation 1. Okay, put RB in equation 1. Put RB in equation 1. So our equation 1 is, no, R, not RB is there, RE is there. Huh? Please correct this. Here R E into 10. Here again 10 into R E and finally R E, which is equal to 29. R E, which is equal to 29. So R A plus R E, which is equal to how much? 60. Okay. So R A plus 29 which is equal to 60. Therefore, RA which is equal to 60 minus 29. RA which is equal to how much?
31.
Yes, 31 kilonewton. RA which is equal to 31 kilonewton. So these are the reaction calculations. After that, we will calculate, second step is shear force calculations. Second step is shear force calculations. Shear force calculations. Okay, shear force calculations. So whenever we will calculate shear force, you have to remember we will start from this left side. We will start from this A point. Okay, and one simple trick I will give you for this SF calculations. Please remember, okay. Always start from which side? Always start from left side. Start from left side. Always start from left side. And you remember, upward force consider positive and downward force consider negative. बघा काय करायचं आपल्याला लेफ्ट साइड कडून कन्सिडर करायचं आहे अपवर्ड फोर्स पॉझिटिव्ह कन्सिडर करायचं आणि डाउनवर्ड फोर्स निगेटिव्ह कन्सिडर करायचं तर आरए ची व्हॅल्यू किती आहे आपली आरए विच इज इक्वल टू 31 आणि आरई विच इज इक्वल टू 29 ओके आता तुम्ही लिहू नका लक्ष द्या थोडं सगळे जण इकडं लेफ्ट साइड पासून स्टार्ट करायचं आहे अपवर्ड फोर्स पॉझिटिव्ह डाउनवर्ड फोर्स निगेटिव्ह आता बघा ए पॉइंट पासून स्टार्ट करतोय ए पॉइंटला फोर्स अपवर्ड आहे का डाउनवर्ड आहे म्हणजे किती घेणार आपण प्लस 31 आता ए टू बी मध्ये कुठला फोर्स आहे का नाहीये आता बी पॉइंटला गेलो तर बी पॉइंटला फोर्स अपवर्ड आहे का डाउनवर्ड आहे
डाउनवर्ड
डाउनवर्ड असल्यावर काय घेतो आपण
मायनस
मायनस 20
मॅडम तुम्ही शेअर फोर्स डायग्राम साइन कन्व्हेन्शन मध्ये असं सांगितलं होतं की क्लॉक वाईज
हे क्लॉक वाईज अँटी क्लॉक वाईज आहे ते तर फॉलो करायचंच आहे पण एक सिम्पल ट्रिक विदाउट वेस्टिंग टाइम कसं ड्रॉ करायचं ते सांगते मी
तुम्हाला होत
होतंय ना कस काय होत नाही आता बघा शिअर फोर्स ऍट ए काय फाइंड आउट करतोय आपण तर इथं आपलं सेक्शन आहे एक्स एक्स डिस्टन्स आहे बरोबर आहे आणि इथं डब्ल्यू फोर्स अप्लाय होतोय डब्ल्यू ठीक आहे हा कुठल्या बीम कुठल्या डायरेक्शनला रोटेट करतोय अपवर्ड नाही क्लॉक वाईज करतोय बरोबर आहे आता ह्या डब्ल्यूला अपोज करण्यासाठी मला कुठे फोर्स द्यावा लागेल इथं डाऊनवर डब्ल्यू द्यावा लागेल का आणि हा डब्ल्यू बीमला कसा रोटेट करतोय क्लॉक वाईज मग बीमचं रोटेशन कसं झालं म्हणजे काय आलं तुमचं पॉझिटिव्ह म्हणजे तेच फॉलो होत इथं सुद्धा तुमचं साइन कन्व्हेन्शन आता लक्षात आलं का संकेत बघा आता आपण ए पॉइंट पासून स्टार्ट केलेला मी परत रिपीट करते ए पॉइंटला हा अपवर्ड जातोय म्हणून आपण इथे घेतलं प्लस 31 ओके आता बी पॉइंटला हा 20 डाउनवर्ड जातोय म्हणून काय घेतलं आपण मायनस 20 आता ह्या दोघांचं कॅल्क्युलेशन करा आणि किती येते सांगा मला प्लस 11 म्हणजे बी पॉइंट पर्यंत शिअर फोर्स किती असणार आहे प्लस 11 आता आपण सी पॉइंटला मूव्ह होतोय सी पॉइंटला लोड अपवर्ड आहे का डाउनवर्ड आहे डाउनवर्ड आहे म्हणजे काय येणार आहे मायनस 30 आता ह्या दोघांचं कॅल्क्युलेशन करा आणि किती येते सांगा मायनस 19 ओके म्हणजे सी पॉइंटला फोर्स हा मायनस 19 येतोय आता आपण डी पॉइंटला फॉरवर्ड होऊया डी पॉइंटला लोड किती आहे 10 किलो न्यूटन डाउनवर्ड सो मायनस 10 सांगा आता किती येणार आहे मायनस
29
आता ई पॉइंटला फोर्स अपवर्ड आहे का डाउनवर्ड आहे अपवर्ड आहे म्हणजे प्लस 29 व्हॅल्यू किती असणार आहे 0 सो हे झाले तुमचे शिअर फोर्सचे कॅल्क्युलेशन्स आता हा पॉइंट कुठला असेल तुमचा ए हा बी हा सी हा डी पॉइंट आहे बरोबर आहे नाही चुकतोय थांबा
आन्सर आलाय तिथं
हा बी पॉइंट हा तुमचा हा बी मिळणार हा सी मिळेल इथे आपण आता डी फोर्स अप्लाय केला म्हणजे हे आन्सर मिळेल आणि ई फोर्सला बिफोर रिएक्शन मायनस 29 असेल आफ्टर रिएक्शन प्लस 29 म्हणजे तुम्ही विदाउट रायटिंग सुद्धा आपण काय करू शकतो शिअर फोर्स कॅल्क्युलेशन करू शकतो पण त्याला आपल्याला काय करायचंय लेफ्ट साइड पासून स्टार्टिंग करायचंय फोर्स अपवर्ड चालला की प्लस डाउनवर्ड येत असेल तर मायनस ओके आता आपण लिहूया shear force at A, which is equal to shear force at A, which is equal to plus 31 kilonewton. Okay. After that, shear force at B, which is equal to at B, but I have B point parent. Plus 31 as it is. And ha 20 kay karto hai? Downward hai. So minus 20, which is equal to plus 11 kilonewton. After that, shear force at C. Shear force at C, which is equal to plus 11 as it is. And C la kay hoto hai? 30 ha downward jato hai. So minus 30, which is equal to how much? Minus 19 kilonewton. After that, shear force at D, which is equal to minus 19 as it is. Minus 19 as it is. D point la kay hote tumcha ha parat downward jato hai. So minus 10, which is equal to minus 29 kilonewton. And shear force at E, which is equal to minus 29 as it is, plus 20 upwards, so 29, which is equal to 0 kilonewton. So these are the shear force calculations. Anybody having doubt in this? Now we will move towards bending moment calculation. So once again, I will draw figure fast and we will find out bending moment values here. This is A point, this is E point, here B, C, D. At B point intensity is 20, at C point intensity is 30, and at D point intensity is 10. Am I right or wrong?
Yes, I'm right.
Okay, 30 kilonewton, 20. Okay, so span between this A to B is 3 meter, and here 2 meter. Okay, now we will do calculations here, bending moment calculation. So first we will start from B point, E point. Okay, bending moment at E, which is equal to, now you tell me, bending moment at E, which is equal to, okay, force is there here, Re, which is there, Re, which is equal to 29, and Ra, which is equal to 31 is there. Okay, baga E point la load tar ahe, pan perpendicular distance kiti ghenaro apan, ani ha jo Re ahe to kay karte, upward push karte, ja veli apan upward push karto tya veli nature kay asnare tumcha sagging asel, manje plus, okay, so plus 29 into perpendicular distance is 0. So bending moment at E, which is equal to 0 kilonewton meter. After that, we will calculate bending moment at D. Next is bending moment at D. Bending moment at D, which is equal to bending moment at D, which is equal to, I will draw figure here. So this is 29 kilonewton force. Here D point is there, perpendicular distance is 2. Okay, so which is equal to, now this 20 again pushes upward, that means sagging nature will be there. So plus 29 into perpendicular distance is how much? 2 meter, which is equal to, so you calculate 29 into 2, which is equal to 58 kilonewton meter. After that, next we will find out bending moment at, next point is bending moment at C point. Okay, bending moment at C. For this again, I will draw figure here up to C. Okay, so this is 29 force is going here, 10 kilonewton force is there. Okay, this distance is 2 meter. Here C point is there. Okay, and this distance is 3 meter. Now you tell me, moment, this 20 pushes upwards, that is sagging nature. So plus 29 into perpendicular distance is how much from this E point to C? 5. Okay. This 10 kilonewton force pushes downward. That means hogging nature will be there. So minus 10 into perpendicular distance is how much? 3 meter, which is equal to. So you calculate and tell me bending moment at C, which is equal to how much?
100. 115. Ma'am, 3 meter, 10 into
3. बघा, D point पासून C point पर्यंत span किती है?
3
meter. मग force into perpendicular distance किती असणार आहे? 3 असेल, म्हणून 10 into 3 घेतलं. म्हणजे किती आलं तुमचं इथे? 115 kilonewton meter. 115 kilonewton meter. Okay. Okay, we will solve fast. Okay, so bending moment at C, which is equal to 115. After that, we will calculate bending moment at B. Okay, bending moment at B. So you tell me fast, bending moment at B, which is equal to? Bending moment at B, which is equal to. So for this, suppose we will consider from this left side. From this left side. Okay. So here RA force is there, intensity is 31. And from this A point to B point, perpendicular distance is 3 meter. So moment is, okay, this pushes upward again. So moment is plus 31 into perpendicular distance is 3, which is equal to bending moment is how much? 93 kilonewton meter. 93 kilonewton meter. And then we will find out bending moment at A. Last point is there. Bending moment at A, which is equal to. Bending moment at A, which is equal to. Okay, for that I will draw figure here. Okay, so you observe here. Bending moment at A. Value is there. 31 into perpendicular distance with how much?
0.
0. So bending moment at A, which is equal to 0 kilonewton meter. So these are the calculations for bending moment. Okay. I request all of you, please write down fast. Okay. We will draw shear force and bending moment diagram in next lecture. Okay. You try to draw shear force and bending moment diagram. Okay. Write down fast. Today we will stop here. Shear force diagram and bending moment diagram we will draw in next lecture. Okay, we'll stop here. Thank you for attending lecture. Thank you.